Good morning, students. Today, in module 1, we'll be discussing about the circulatory system, the cardiovascular system. The learning objectives are to understand the heart, its structure and function, and to understand the cardiovascular or circulatory system. Human and other vertebrates have a closed circulatory system. What does that mean? That means that circulating blood is pumped through a system of vessels. This system consists of heart, pump, series of blood vessels, and the blood that flows through them. What is the heart? It is located near the center of your chest. It is a hollow structure. It is composed almost entirely of muscles which are known as cardiac muscles. It is about the size of your clenched fist. This is the size of your heart. It is enclosed in a protective sac called the pericardium. In the walls of the heart, there's two layers of tissue which form a sandwich around a thick layer of muscle which is called myocardium. The contraction of the myocardium pumps blood through the circulatory system. The heart contracts about 72 times per minute. It pumps about 70 ml of blood with each contraction. The right and left sides of the heart are separated by a septum or wall. The septum prevents the mixing of oxygen-rich and oxygen-poor blood. On each side of the septum are two chambers. The upper chamber received blood is the atrium, and the lower chamber pumps blood out of heart is the ventricle. The heart has a total of four chambers, two atriums and two ventricles. Now the pathway of blood. See, the deoxygenated blood passes from the right atrium into the right ventricle and then goes to the lungs. From the lungs, blood moves back towards the heart into the atrium to the left ventricle and then passes into the aorta to go to the rest of the body. What are valves? As the heart contracts, blood flows into the ventricles and then out through the ventricles. Flaps of connective tissues are called valves and are located between the atria and ventricles. Blood moving keeps the valves open. When the ventricles contract, the valves close, which prevent blood from flowing back into the atria. There are also valves that stop blood from re-entering the ventricles after the blood has left. This system of valves keep blood moving in one direction, which increases the pumping efficiency of the heart. What is heartbeat? Heart muscles are composed of individual fibers. Each atrium and ventricle contracts as a unit. Each contraction begins with a group of cardiac muscle cells in the right atrium, known as the sinoatrial node or SA node. Because the SA node paces the heart, it is known as the pacemaker. The impulse spreads from the pacemaker to the rest of the atria. From the atria, signal is sent to the atrioventricular node or AV node and then to the bundle of fibers in the ventricle. When the ventricle contracts, the blood flows out. What are the blood vessels? As blood moves through the circulatory system, it moves through three types of blood vessels: arteries, capillaries, and veins. Arteries. These are large vessels which carry blood from heart to tissues of body. They carry oxygen-rich blood with the exception of pulmonary artery. These are thick wall which need to withstand pressure produced when heart pushes blood into them. Capillaries. These are the smallest blood vessels. Walls are only one cell thick and very narrow. Important for bringing nutrient and oxygen to tissues and absorbing carbon dioxide and other waste products. What are veins? Once blood has passed through the capillary system, it must be returned to the heart. It is done by veins. Walls contain connective tissue and smooth muscle. This largest vein contain one-way valves that keep blood flowing towards heart. Many found near skeletal muscles. When muscles contract, blood is forced through the veins. What is blood pressure? The heart produces pressure. The force of blood on the wall of the arteries is known as blood pressure. Blood pressure decreases as the heart relaxes, but the rest of the circulatory system is still under pressure. When blood pressure is taken, the cuff is wrapped around the upper portion of the arm and pumped with air until blood flow in the artery is blocked. As the pressure in the cuff is relaxed, two numbers are recorded. One is the systolic pressure, the other is the diastolic pressure. The systolic pressure is the force felt in the arteries when the ventricles contract, and the diastolic pressure is the force of the blood of the arteries when the ventricles relax. What are the learning outcomes? To apply the concept of the heart, its structure and function, and to apply the concept of the cardiovascular system. Thank you.